Hey everybody, welcome to another Redstone video. Today I want to show you three GameTick pulse generators. I came up with five unique designs when I needed one a few weeks ago for a cactus farm, and I just want to show you a bunch in case you ever need one. Generally, a three GameTick pulse generator is useful if you need to work with really sharp timings, because it's the shortest pulse where a piston would extend and retract without losing the block again, and the 3 game tick pulse can also be easily converted in a 0 tick pulse. So that's why this is useful. Maybe let's start with some terminology first, because you might not be aware of the 3 game tick pulse or the game tick pulses. You might only know the redstone tick pulses, which are, for example, the repeater uses, also redstone torches or comparators. Here you can see a repeater on two redstone ticks. One redstone tick equals two game ticks. The game runs at 20 ticks per second, but only 10 redstone ticks per second. So what's important about short pulses, which basically pulses that are 2 ticks or shorter, is that sticky pistons would drop the block. So here we have an observer, which gives out a 2 game tick pulse or 1 redstone tick pulse. This causes the sticky piston to drop the block. So if you got the next higher redstone tick delay, this is a repeater on 2 redstone ticks or 4 game ticks. This would cause the sticky piston to extend and retract the block again. But there's actually a pulse that is shorter than a 4 tick pulse, where the sticky piston still extends and retracts the block again. Obviously the 3 game tick pulse. And you can't get that by using observers, repeaters, torches, and comparators alone. We need pistons for that. So here we got the first design involving a sticky piston, a redstone block, and a comparator on subtract mode. So the idea here is that we power the comparator and also the sticky piston here. And after 3 ticks, we basically turn off the comparator again because it's getting powered from the side. Alright, here's a demonstration. This piston of the redstone block fully extends and retracts. And here you can also see that you got extending redstone block and retracts again. This would 0 tick this piston here. Can demonstrate it in 1.13 and above. The cactus wouldn't get destroyed by an extending piston. So one more note, the system currently only works because we have a button input. It wouldn't work with a redstone torch input, or a repeater input, or a comparator input. Because there's an oddity in the game, button inputs and repeater delays, and also moving blocks powering other sticky pistons with a block in front. So what happens now, if you press a button, this comparator would turn on after 1 tick, instead of the usual 2 ticks, game ticks that is. It takes 2 ticks for a block to extend, so I press the button, after 1 tick this turns on. After 2 ticks, the redstone block arrives on the side, then takes another additional 2 ticks until the comparator would turn off. So it's powered from tick 1 to 4, kinda, so we got a 3 tick pulse. Now if you would use a repeater instead, then it takes the usual 2 game ticks or 1 redstone tick until the comparator turns on. And also this redstone block would arrive after 2 ticks, then takes another 2 ticks until this one turns off again, until the signal of the block on the side is processed. So in total we get a 2 game tick pulse, in case we have a repeater input, as you can see here. So that's why this would only work with the button input. But of course we can make a workaround, in case you have an automatic system and need a 3 game tick pulse somehow. Then there's also the workaround. We could use moving blocks. Moving blocks, pistons getting activated by moving blocks, wait an additional 1 tick. So what happens if I move the block over, this comparator turns on in front after 2 ticks, once the block arrives, but here the piston waits an additional tick before it starts extending, and the block arrives after 3 ticks. And then after 5 ticks, comparator turns off. So 3 ticks from 2 to 5, kinda, where it's on. It's okay, I can also demonstrate it. This would, of course, now work for repeater input as well. And clicking here the button, as you can see, you get the 3 game tick pulse. Alright, so this was the first example. Then, yeah, I built up four more 3 game tick pulse generators. The next one actually works a similar fashion. Like, we get the 0 tick pulse from the 3 tick pulse. Basically, each piston of redstone block in a chain, the delay is decreased. So for each chain link, the delay is decreased by 3 ticks. So if I would input a 6 tick pulse here, then here we get a 3 tick pulse, 0 tick pulse. But yeah, this only works if a piston is powered directly. If I would put a repeater here, then we get a 4 tick pulse here. So this would, if you need a 3 tick pulse, that is, I don't know, triggering a piston directly, so you can't put a repeater in between, then this is a way to go. The nice thing about the one with the comparator is that a repeater could also transmit that signal over there, and we still get a 3 tick delay. Over here, for example, 3 game tick pulse. It's just important that the repeaters are set to 1. If you would set 1 to 2, then the pulse is also lengthened and we get a 4 tick pulse. Then the next one is cutting a redstone dust signal. There's also multiple ways how to do it, and also it's going to be important if you use a repeater or not. So let's try out the first one. We just cut a redstone signal here with a sticky piston that extends a block. So this would work with a player input to get a 3 game tick pulse here, but also a redstone input. Okay. So what's only important is the you have to look at the redstone dust here. So that's why it would also work with repeater. It's also a nice way to get some repeater in between in case you ever need it for additional delay. But here it's now important that you have either button input or a block that is getting pushed. Otherwise, if you would use a repeater, then it doesn't work. You can also take a look at the delays, why it doesn't work. So if you have the repeater input, then we basically push this over, and after 2 ticks, the wire is cut. If you would have a button input here, then this actually turns on after 1 tick already, and the block is pushed over, it arrives after 2 ticks, and yeah, then it's gonna be on for 2 ticks more, and it's gonna turn off after 4. Alright, another example, this would also wouldn't work if you have a repeater here and there, obviously, because then we got 2 ticks of delay here and 2 ticks until the block arrives, so we get a 4 tick pulse here. Okay. That's really important if you use repeaters or not. Hope this is clear. Then the next one, it is hopefully easy to understand. This is a really nice one. This is what I ended up using for my cactus farm. It's using the new leaf mechanics in Minecraft 1.13. So here we got a sticky piston, or normal piston, doesn't matter in this case, that pushes over a lock block, ends up on top of this redstone torch, and powers this repeater. Then we got 1 tick of delay here with the leaves, which this observer detects, and powers this piston here via QC. Here at the bottom we just use the node block in order to update the piston. So yeah, we got 1 tick of delay with the leaf, 2 ticks of delay for the observer, so the block sits there for 3 ticks. And as you can see, we get a 3 game tick output that works with repeater. This one works with repeater, but not with a redstone dust, because then yeah, the piston would wait an additional tick longer before it extends, so because it's activated by a moving block, and that's why this piston would only be powered for 2 ticks, so it can extend. Alright, next example, then here we got, yeah, quite similar to the lock, but we don't use the leaf mechanic. We push over a redstone block, it's also getting quickly pulsed by this observer here, and then we activate this sticky piston, which waits for a tick, and then pushes over another redstone block under this piston, which causes the piston to extend, redstone block is moved over again, and in the end, we got a 3 tick pulse on this line, but only if you put power a piston directly. In case you would put a repeater in between, then this would actually be a 4 tick pulse. Okay. So here we would have, if you pass something directly, a 3-tick pulse, you can also show it. Actually, we're doing this over here already. We're pushing in the redstone block, and this would 0-tick the piston here. Actually, this piston is also 0-tick, pushes the block back. Alright, so that's it. It's a bit complicated. I would also recommend maybe to watch some videos that I link in a video description that explain it a bit more detail, how the exact delays work of the redstone components. Yeah, but for practical applications, you can just, I don't know, just use those little setups. You can also use those without really understanding all the little details about it. That's it. Hope this was useful for you, and in case you ever need some sharp timings or you want to create some 0-ticks, maybe also for a cactus farm. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next video. Bye bye.